Good afternoon and welcome back to the Harbor Hangar. We're out at Rocket City RC again, and the Black Widow has paint and decals. Thanks, Dan Sponholz, for the decals. And it is ready to fly. We got the CG forward. I repaired the nose gear from last time, and turns out the main gear just needed to be like reset in position. They're fine. So we're good to go. We're gonna put a battery in it and away we go.
Take a deep breath.
There's a gust at my back. I'm gonna do a taxi test. Waiting for the wind to go a little less cross. Right now it's literally straight across the field. All right, taking off.
Fine enough. What are you doing? Flying is number one.
Turbulent. Landing. Oof. 149. Oh no.
Again.
Well, that's not good.
Now, the nose got completely jammed in the grass.
Safe.
Daddy.
Hold the nose gear.
It's not in one piece.
It's in one. Well, yeah, right. It's in two pieces. All right. Oh man, look at that. That nose gear just snapped right off. Well, we lost the nose gear again. There it is, sheared right off. I think I need to invest into some better landing gear. I think that might be a good lesson that I probably should have learned one or two crashes ago. But, you know, this is what you do. You use what you got until you don't got it anymore, and then you learn and move on. So, the main just folded up. It looked like it busted off, but it just kind of folded. And that's because the mechanism was weakened from the last crash. So probably a good idea to order some new mains and put those in. But the good news overall is that, you know, the nose gear just sheared off, and that's, I can just unscrew and put a new one on. And the mains are also easily removable and replaceable. And the nose, okay, I gotta probably gotta cut the nose off and put a new nose on, because that's getting a little sad. But that's an easy enough fix, just to cut the nose off, put a new nose on, paint it black. But other than that, it's intact, and it flew good, it felt good. It's kind of cross and turbulent today, so the approach was difficult, but at least we got it down in 1.9 pieces, whatever, mostly one piece. I'm happy with it. Hey, thanks, bud, for getting some video. And thanks again to Dan Sponnels for the decals. Thanks to all of you who originally supported the fundraiser on the Super Super Hornet, because that is where all the internal guts from this came from. And if you like this plane, if you think this is something that you'd want to try and build, I do have plans. I can put them up. I'm a little wary to share them because of how much of a handful this is. But if you built it lighter than I've done, it would probably be a lot more well-behaved. And now we know exactly where the CG wants to be if you don't have, you know, a fancy schmancy computer to fly it with. The flaps and the leading edge flaps and the elevator trim worked great. That when I had them dialed down to full flaps on approach, and it slowed it down. It slowed it down quite nicely. I was happy with how that worked. So I can say that yes, the leading edge flaps there, they function and they do make a good difference. Oh, here's a question that people sometimes ask, and I might as well point it out. The elevators here, they're all moving, but they're not elevons. They don't move with pitch and roll. They are ruddervators. So that means they're coupled with rudder and elevator. So they couple for pitch and yaw, which is a little bit different than what you normally see with all moving tails. So we've got full flaperons, so these both move with ailerons, and these deflect for flaps. And then the all moving tails deflect for pitch and rudder, and then we've got leading edge flaps. Sometimes people might call them slats, but normally slats slide out, they don't hinge, and these are actually just simple hinge leading edge flaps. Little things. Anyway, that's it for the Black Widow 2 for today. We will get some new gear under her, because other than this and the crunchy nose, she's good to go. She's still in one piece. So I am pleased. We're not gonna trash this jet. We're gonna keep her around for a while and put her in the air another day. Thanks for hanging out with me here at Rock City RC, and thanks for following the Harbor Hangar. We'll check you next time. Bye.